G'day there, welcome to Temporal Paradox 1. In this tutorial, I want to show you how to record audio direct to the timeline using a microphone in Vegas. Now to do this, there's a little bit of pre-preparation, okay? Otherwise, you'd probably be banging your head against a brick wall for quite a few days. And that is setting up the microphone you're going to use. Now, if you're going to do any sort of recording, then I highly recommend that you're using a USB microphone or some sort of good quality microphone which you've been able to patch into your computer. Those microphones that come with laptops are just, they're toys. They're not worth it. Okay, so you've connected your USB microphone. Then you have to go into the sound driver for your computer. Now, in most computers, you'll have like a little speaker here. Right click and click on recording devices. And if the driver for the microphone is installed correctly, it'll be showing just here, microphone, USB audio device. Now, just because you've connected it doesn't mean it's ready to be used. Next thing you'll have to do is right click on top of it, or however your software works, and find the properties. And what I highly recommend you do is turn off, if you have the selection AGC, turn it off. That's automatic gain control. And if that's selected, it'll make the recording volume go up and down like a yo-yo and sound terrible. So click that off. Levels is the most important thing. It's probably something, you know, you need to do little 10-second recordings backwards and forwards to get your levels right. Record something, play it back, listen to it in headphones and see if it's at the right level. And so muck around with doing that and then your recording will be a lot better. So do all that first. The second step is you need to change some things in the back room of Vegas. So go into Options, Preferences, Audio Device, and once again, different computers behave differently, but I've found on three of my computers that I have to change this to Windows Classic Wave Driver, and that then brings up the driver for my computer. Now it's correctly showing here the Realtek high definition speakers, that's cool. But the most important thing of all is down here is that your USB microphone has been selected. Make sure it doesn't do something weird like select your speakers, that's not going to work. So do that, click apply, click OK, and now you're almost ready to start recording. So you can use any, you can add in an extra audio track, do whatever you want. In my little example here, I'll just use the music layer. And all you basically do is press the record button, the arm for record first. And first thing it's going to ask you is, where is this sound file going to be saved? So at this stage, you can navigate to exactly where you want that to be saved. So for me, I would be putting that into my Movie Studio project folder. And if you've already saved the project, you could put it into the particular project folder that you're working on right now. Anyway, click OK. Click OK. And you notice now that the level meter is working. The one thing you definitely want to make sure is that the recording level is not going into the red zone. Otherwise, it'll be clipping and it'll sound terrible. One last step to go now. Prepare yourself. Have a drink of water. Do a bit of meditation. And press the record button down here on the timeline. And now everything will start to record. But of course, so while I'm doing that, I've just realized that the audio from my video up here is also playing. And that's annoying. So you can always disable that while you're recording. And that's it. When you're finished, click the record button again, and then it'll ask you if you want to save it or get rid of it if it was crap. So if you like it, just press done, and there you are, there's your recording. The final step is remember to disarm, and then what you can do is sex up your voice by hitting the track effects button there. And by default, there's three plugins already added in to any audio layer in Vegas. This track equalizer here is pretty cool. So if your microphone's, you know, not the best quality and you want your voice to sound a bit better, you can muck around with the settings here. So, you know, for example, if I was to push that up there, that would help increase the bass and sort of give more depth to my voice. But vice versa, if it was too bassy, you could do the reverse, okay? But that's all sort of stuff that you can experiment by yourself and muck around for hours getting that right. And always remember too that if you press that, you can have access to all the other plugins that are available. So there you go. That's how you record audio direct to the timeline in Vegas. Have fun, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And I'll catch you next time.